pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing for a moment of silence for the sick, the handicapped, the departed military personnel of this community. Thank you.
Roll call, please.
Here.
Salvucci.
She'll be here shortly.
Nino Petrocelli.
Here.
Jason Sarasnick.
Here.
Bill Borough. Bill Henderson.
Here.
Bill Owen.
Here.
Grant Hoppercamp.
Here.
Solicitor Thomas McDermott.
Here.
And Deirdre Sites.
Here.
Borough Manager Laura Cullen.
Here.
Police Chief Chad King.
Here.
Fire Chief Bill Chilio. Southbridge EMS General.
Here.
Bill Chilio, we don't have enough cover over at the bingo, so that's why it's not good. Bingo.
You guys did a good job.
Yeah. All right, our first visitor, Mary Weiss.
Yes, here I am again. I'm still representing the Historic Society, so I brought these with me because you're all going to be invited. Pass them along. And if there are any left, please send your audience statement. I have to say this, that I miss seeing a lot of you last Friday evening at the services over at Holy Child. Just to say this, we missed you, and do you remember where you were September 11th, 2001? I'll leave you with that thought and go on and say you're all invited to come to our next program and all our programs. They are free, open to the public. Todd DePastina, I think, still teaches one day a week at Waynesburg U. He is in charge of all the Southwestern Pennsylvania Veterans Breakfasts. He has written books, and he's coming to speak to us about the home front, what it was like during World War II. Excellent speaker, top notch speaker. And last but not least, I want this in the records, please. We are totally 501c3. We do not take tax money. We do not ask for it. We're not on your list for taxes. No, we're a 501c3. And believe me, we work hard to get up to 24. Well, we've only gone over 25,000 once, and that threw us in the arms of the IRS. So we're happy if we get 18,000 a year, but that's what we need to keep going. So if you find an opportunity to write a check or drop off some green, we'd love to have that too. But back again, we are 501c3. We do not accept tax money. And don't forget to come to bring your families, students, you're all invited. Thank you.
Thank you, Mary. Mrs. Falcone?
Yes. I'd like to say thank you for Bridge Road. It is a great improvement. I have two other questions. Number one, do we have an ordinance against parking, or parking with fixed streets?
It's a state law.
I know that, but they said they were going to enforce it on Baldwin Street. That's what I'm asking.
Once everything was redone,
okay, then we was enforce that on any street?
Technically, yes. But how picky do you want us to be on something like that?
Just ask it. Okay, number two, how or when can we find out if there's going to be a stop sign? I live on Pedro Metro, and we would prefer not to have a stop sign coming down when they open that street on May for the Bednar Estates.
Yes. I can look at it.
Who is in charge? I mean, them or us?
We are, as far as our traffic study went, when all of this started, there was no stop sign presented at that intersection. They'll have a stop sign coming
up. Absolutely.
But but there was nothing presented coming down for the residents.
We just wanted to make sure that we weren't the ones that had to stop.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Thank you very much.
Mr. Fryer.
Yes, sir. When I was here last, it's my game that was here, the traffic each year from Gateway. I think it was a lot of vacation. And I emphasize once again, the name is so essential that Washington might be wide from Bridgeville to Four Lane into South Bend, to Daniel Drive, and maybe three lanes from there to Burska. And we talked about, I mentioned that some of the business owners had suggested they might even give the land to PennDOT along the way, four or five of them. And we were talking about what the cost estimate would be to actually do the wider, longer plan, and again, the possibility of donating another land. Some of them mentioned they might contribute funds for it. But I think it was you might mention that those are sort of arbitrary points of discussion. What we need is a drawing, an engineering drawing made by Gateway, so that we know what the costs are, and if someone is going to give us 140 feet of their front yard, or 12 feet or something, that we know what the value of the contribution is. But my question is, where is the drawing? What stage are you getting us the drawing so we can take the next step?
We didn't do a drawing for that part of South Bend.
This is the task force.
Right. We didn't do a drawing for that. There was an initial drawing with P.B. Shepherd.
That's right. P.B. Shepherd had developed a conceptual plan for that portion of Route 50 through South Fayette.
Yes.
And then that is a matter of, you know, all the way down, all the way
to Boyce Road.
Right, Boyce Road, and maybe even going a little bit further, the concept where it would tie into the turnpike blob.
The Southern Beltway.
Yeah. So, I mean, it's a matter of, you know, South Fayette giving the green light to the task force to come up with more detailed drawings to prepare the cost estimates. Mm-hmm.
So, Haberman, so the task force, I guess you guys haven't had a meeting since I met here.
No, we have not.
So it's up to the task force to tell the traffic engineer, yeah, go ahead and do the drawing, because we need more specific. Am I correct?
Yes, yeah. We did not meet this.
Yeah, I'm pleading on bended knee.
I understand. Okay. And I think, you know, we explained to you one of the, you know, roadblocks. You mentioned that there's business owners that would gladly give up right away,
right.
But we're under the impression that there are also several businesses that will not be as favorable to that plan.
Yeah, there's one especially.
And we were told that if you go after this, it's going to delay this process.
It's another phase.
So they said, you know, it's there, the four lanes are there. Concentrate on the bridge and what you get now, and then we'll go just like, because we're not going to, it isn't like we're going to tear the whole thing up and build it all at one time. It's going to be done in phases, obviously.
Okay, well, let me suggest and advise you that's not the way to do it. Let's be open. Excuse me, you can go. I've talked to half a dozen engineers that know more than you and I know about it. They agree.
I wasn't able.
That's all right. Okay. My point is, McDonald's, the restaurant's been very uncooperative, not only with refusing to meet with me, but refusing to meet with the manager of South Head Township, an engineer. All three of us, probably four or five times, stopped over there to try to catch the owner. It's, I think it's Rice Productions, and it's 15 different McDonald's restaurants, you know. But my point is, they're left turn snagging lane going into McDonald's has to be eliminated. But there are other ways that they can get in there. And my point in recommending that you not consider two-phase, I guess, you can't let a left turn snagging lane into a fast food store or a restaurant prevent a four-lane widening of that section of Washington Pike to South Fayette Central Business, high into ours. That essentially does. The first phase you're talking about, Tom, or I'm sorry, Mike, is the widening. I'm glad everybody likes widening the Chartier Street from the railroad bridge down, so that allows two lanes down Chartier, seven-lane bridge, two lanes going across the bridge to the left, and two lanes back on. But that doesn't do Bridgeville South yet, as much as that's essentially. So I'd really caution you about it being a little more difficult.
We haven't had a task force meeting, and I know we should have one in the near future.
Good.
We'll bring it up. I'll make sure.
It's not something that we ignored.
No.
It's something that we know that needs to be done. And we're working toward what can we get done now.
Right. What you characterize as gaping is not gaping. That piece of the puzzle, that's like stating the obvious. I mean, please don't leave a suggestion that folks aren't thinking about the necessity and the desirability. Sure, I mean, if we had all the money in the world, we'd go straight down where, you know, he just said right now. But we have a lot of balls in the ears, and we're one of four players in the least in this matter. And as far as Bristol's concerned, frankly, we've gone through on several occasions dealing with all these folks, and basically the takeaway that Bridgeville kind of could benefit out of what we're calling phase one, which isn't just a phase one. I mean, clipping off the stuff on the bridge, which is the right, that's the 79 loop thing, and then the chart terrace, okay? And in talking with all folks and what's best strategically to go after right now, not to the exclusion of other things, but right now, given what the realities are of where you can get the money, how you can fund things, and how you can make things happen. Frankly, I think I can speak for Joe and Lori and say we're very pleasantly surprised at what's coming together in regard to phase one. As far as that section of it, again, to me, that's stating the obvious, and I think, like he said, that dime is going to flip automatically once the first stuff is in place, and probably before it's over. I mean, if you even look at the real estate market, I mean, when it's time for that to go, and the stuff develops on each side of the street, you know, believe me, when somebody needs to upgrade that, they will buy it, they will get the right away, they will negotiate, and that road will get wide, and anybody riding down there, even enough to be an engineer to say,
talking about Washington,
it's
like
there.
South Bend.
The places that you're talking about, beyond our stretch, down to Burst and the whole nine yards. Of course, everybody wants to do it. And frankly, that's in the heart of South Bay. That's baby. Not that it's not something we want as well, right? Mm-hmm. But as far as what we're able to get now, what we're able to achieve most efficiently, and what we're going to be able to get, you know, maybe that synergy one stuff, a momentum one to lead to the other stuff, to me, that's going to be the shoe that drops automatically after we achieve the first
one. What you just described is certainly a logical approach, but let me tell you what makes me nervous. 25 years ago, 1990, a couple of the old timers here can verify this. We proposed, I was on the Bridgeville Planning Commission at the time, we proposed the same exact thing as we proposed on, like a five-lane bridge instead of a seven or something. And it was supported by the news media, it was supported by the Chamber of Commerce, it was supported by Bridgeville Council and South Bay officials. The PennDOT told us, it's unnecessary to widen Washington Pike, even the part from the post office to the bridge and up through South Ed, because they were going to build a new interchange on I-79 at the west end of Boyce Road.
I thought you were not saying this is not. That's all very interesting.
I want to make my point though. What happened is, because they did not build the interchange, Bridgeville and South Fayette have had the economic development in their communities suppressed for
35, let me make my point for 35 years. I know you know what I'm saying, maybe the others don't. What's happened is, not only the fact that there was no realtors who built in Bridgeville, and in Southend until recently, the taxes on the families has been higher than it should be. But my point is, I don't trust PennDOT that they will build, so let's say they do the Chartier Street and 7 Lane Bridge over to Route 99. I'd get a timetable that they complete another 3 years, but when you look at the complications of closing down 20 businesses to the left and the right when they do the construction, and which might even make a couple of them go bankrupt, and then doing it a second time, it's not a good idea. I'd like to see you guys be hard-nosed enough to say, we want the whole thing, we want it done right now, because there are engineers who will support the idea. I'll tell you the truth, I think, in terms of the features of the plan, Haberman supports it, and I'm assuming Joe does as well. At any rate,
everybody supports it, Bob, including PennDOT, and we are in a cooperative, I think, mode with PennDOT. We've been very happy with their cooperation with us. I think Southend and Upstate and us all as well. Certainly, they've never ceased lobbying for all of that, and every time trying to get everything we can get. But appreciate the failure to dig at that is not a failure in the context of this phase. But what we want right now, and I can assure you, this board has a foot on the pedal, and they ain't going to blame it off.
Well, I know it's a matter of money and funding, but my point is, Bridgeville, the people in the town, and the families, and the business owners have suffered so much that most of them are unaware of, that I feel PennDOT, the funding people, owe us the extra funding now to do both phase one and phase two. That's my point.
Thanks, Bob.
Yeah, good. I appreciate the
amount of problems. He was the last visitor. Was there anybody else that?
Frank Daly with Burke speaks in Wingbuck. The reason for my visit tonight basically was September 10th is whenever we found out that there was a significant change in the cost of parking in not only a lot across the street, but I guess I assume in the lots in Bridgeville. Went from a quarter for an hour to 75 cents for an hour. And my math tells me that's a 300% increase in parking fees. And that came on the heels of a 40% increase in the meter violation fines that went from $5 to $7. And when that information came to us, the 75 cent an hour change, it came from the customers that walked through our doors that were putting money in the meters, all right? That communication came from those folks. There was no communication from the parking authority. That day, I actually sent an email to the mayor asking him what role the Bridgeville Council, what role the parking authority played. Well, how did they make the business justification for a 300% increase in the parking in the local lots here? In addition to that, why was advance notice, communication, cooperation with local business owners and the people that use it or the residents in Bridgeville, what role did they play or where was that communication and participation? And from what I'm gathering, there really wasn't any. Local businesses using the lot. The other thing I had a question on, so when it all came to me, I said, well, okay, I'll go to the Borough website. Look on the Borough website, see if there's any information on the Borough website about this significant change. Not one bit of information on the website about the change. No communication, go on to the thing, went from there to the parking authority, the information page of the parking authority, nothing there. So as a business owner, and also in behalf of my customers that come to the door, there's a concern there. So the next piece of the puzzle, I did ask, and I was able to secure from the mayor's office, a copy of the July month-end financial statement. And there's the month of July only, and 7 months ending July 31st of 2016.
Financial statement.
The parking authority.
Oh, because we are, so we're separate.
I understand that. Parking authority operates separately.
Yeah.
And I'm aware of that. So that's why I wanted to see what, where is their business justification for such a significant change in the parking fees? So just throwing a little bit of math to some of the numbers, just to kind of get a feel for the financial influence of this impact this is gonna have for the parking authority. So if I went on and I added up the revenue just for the month of July, the revenues for the meters in Lot 1, Lot 2, Lot 4, and Lot 5. And I did have a question looking at this because it shows in the financial statement the revenue for those four lots, but Lot 3 is missing. They don't show any revenue for Lot 3 there. If I add up the revenue just from the meters for those four lots for the month of July, that's $5,160. I add 300% to that. That takes that revenue to $15,480. Then the next one of these interesting
items.
Pardon me? What are those numbers again?
What went from what to what?
$5,160 for those four lots. Lot 3's revenue was not listed, and I don't know why. I guess part of that. Because Lot 3 is listed as far as an asset on their financial statement, but it doesn't show any revenue on this statement. So that's $5,160. 300% takes that up to $15,480. The next big number on the revenue is the unallocated fines collected for the month of July. $3,377.24. Now, I would assume that we're going to get a big significant increase in the meters, and actually that was the largest revenue generator for the month of July, was the fines. If there was a 300% increase in the number of fines, because now people are having less quarters to go in the meter, everything else, more activity, that would drive that fine number from $3,377 to $10,131. So just taking those two additional revenue increases, if your total revenue for the month of July before that was $12,758, the new revenue would be $29,832.
These are projections.
Pardon me?
These are projections.
Well, these would, you would make assumptions based on a 300% increase in the meter fees. And maybe, you know, the fines collected, maybe a little bit excess number, but I don't know if it would be a true 300%, but there's a significant impact there. You all made on to the operating expenses for the month of July, and the financial statement is $8,910. So if my assumptions are even close to $29,800, take away $8,900, the bargaining authority is going to have a net revenue for the month of July, or as an assumption, of almost $21,000. Where I'm challenged is where was the business decision-making process? How did the parking authority make this decision? Like I said, I'm not aware of any business owners that were involved in this conversation. I saw nothing that was published about it, nothing that was posted. The people came, put their boards in the meter, when it started, and just sharing the frustration, I know, business owners and people that use the lot. And the last thing I do want to throw out, so you can take that and throw that to a 12-month process, and you can see significant rise. Now, I do know that when I spoke with the, I don't know if you'd be the president or the person, the individual that is leads the parking authority, I asked them, was this 300% increase across all parking lots, in meter lots in Bridgeville? He said, yes. I said, how about all other meters in Bridgeville? And he said, street meters, no. And I questioned, why not? And he said, street meter parking increases have to be approved by Borough Council. And I'm not sure if that's an accurate statement or not, but I would assume that if it is, then why wouldn't the Borough Council be looking at a significant increase in that? And when I asked the individual, well, why wasn't anybody involved, he had no answer. Okay? So the frustration is customers that come into our lot, come into our business, come into our lot. Like I said, now they go out, they get a fine. They can't throw their money in a box, in an envelope, and stick it in the box. They have to go online, pay it, pay another dollar and a half or $2, whatever they're getting charged, and pay it online. So now it went from 5 to 7 to almost 9 to be paid online.
900%.
Okay? And is the fee, is the fine now $9 too, or is that?
That's my daughter's thing.
Okay. All right? Don't. My question to council would be, heard the question because I understand that making any change to this probably would be slim enough. But how come the parking authority can go with that type of power and make such a significant impact to the business community and the people that come into our town day in and day out? You know, you go back to I am one of the biggest businesses or the entire that's against the June day. Okay, because it just shuts me down for a day. But the whole reason for that Bridgeville days is to try and bring people into Bridgeville.
Right.
Show them they're a nice community.
Right.
All right. We have nice businesses. Come shop here. Come eat here. Come enjoy our community. But then we're going to hit you like this when you come park your car. That's what frustrates me. And then the last thing, my last point is one of our customers did put a nice little message on Facebook. She said, new parking meters in Bridgeville. Only takes quarters, 75 cents an hour now. So now we're gonna run around with all quarters, number one. Number two, those meters take no paper and no credit cards. And it's 2015 was her statement. So that's my my piece. I don't know if you have any direction for me, but I just feel that.
Frank, at this point, what I'll tell you is that we'll look into talking to the parking and find out what we can do.
Okay, I appreciate that. I need to get off of here.
I just want to know, how are we supposed to know that? What he's talking about?
You're right, I agree with you.
Yeah, you don't just communicate. Our customers told us.
It's a good thing they can talk.
You know, and then on top of it, they go out there and they get their fine, you know, because they didn't realize their quarter when they thought they were coming in for an hour, they're going for 20 minutes. And then they got it twice. No warnings, not.
Right. Hey, Frank, have you took your grievance to the parking authority?
Not yet. That's next week. We just became aware of September 10th. Did we have any official date? Is there an official date of when this all changed? Did I even ask somebody, when did they change all the meters? Because that just didn't happen. Did they do it in the middle of the night? Because I never saw anybody in the lot doing any of the work changing the meters. And they had to change every meter in every lot. And I never saw anybody doing any work. And they're all different meters. Meters take quarters and dimes, and there's a note right on there, quarters only. And I am aware, I think they came from somewhere else. Just, okay?
I appreciate it.
Thank you.
I'll look
appreciate it.
Frank. Anybody else? I took my favorite sandwich off of bed. On to our regular business. Minutes. Motion of the Borough Council regarding the minutes of August 10th, 2015 workshop meeting as submitted. And motion of the Borough Council regarding the minutes of August 10th, 2015 regular meeting as submitted.
So moved.
Second. Jason and Bill Henderson. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Current estimate number 4, 2015 point repair project. Motion of the Borough Council regarding the removal of current estimate number 4, 2015 point repair project to Solai Construction in the amount of $43,897.60 for work completed to date. Remarks, the estimate has been reviewed by engineer sites.
No second.
Jason and Bill Henderson. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Police pension, MMO, minimum municipal obligation certification. Motion of Borough Council regarding the receipt of police pension, minimum obligation of $63,379 for the 2016 budget year as prepared by Manager Collins. The pension contribution for 2016 has been calculated to continue at the maximum permitted by Act 600-8%. The actual review is conducted each year to revisit the required contributions.
So moved.
Bill Henderson and Jason, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Non-uniform pension memo, municipal application certification. A motion of the Borough Council regarding the receipt of the non-uniform pension MMO of $25,735 for the 2016 budget year as prepared by Manager Collins. The motion. So Jason?
I'll second.
And Bill Henderson? All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Resolution number 2015-06. A motion of the Borough Council regarding the resolution number 2015-06 as per PennDOT requirements 1.10.14, signs and banners across state highways. The resolution designating the intention of the Borough of the Bridgeville South Fayette Rotary Club to place one banner across State Route 50 to be installed September 15, 2015 and removed October 5th, 2015 for the Rotary Club Chili Cook-Off to be held October 4th, 2015. Motion.
Yes, so
moved. Nino and Neil. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Resolution number 2015-07. Motion of the Borough Council regarding resolution number 2015-07, a resolution of the Borough of Bridgeville deposing the records in compliance with Municipal Records manual approved on July 16, 1993, in accordance with Act 428 of 1968. Per the Municipal Records manual, the public records listed for destruction are hereby listed in Appendix A, page 1, and have been made part of this resolution.
Yes, so
Nino?
Second.
And Bill Henderson. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries.
I said those are all the boxes in the office. All of those are.
Great. A lot of shredding, yes. Resolution number 2015-08. Motion of the Borough Council regarding resolution number 2015-08. A resolution confirming that the Borough of Bridgeville is formally requesting a grant from the Allegheny County Department of Economic Development in the amount of $11,250 for the demolition of a structure located at 781 Barrow Road. The structure has been condemned and abandoned by the owners. Which building is this?
That's the good resident on Barrow Road.
Yes. Excellent. There's a vote. There's a motion.
So moved.
Bill and Nino. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Resolution number 2015-09. Motion of the Borough Council regarding resolution number 2015-09. A resolution confirming that the Borough of Bridgeville determines and declares that such structure identified for demolition individually and collectively constitutes blighted property in the municipality as defined by the Urban Redevelopment Law of 1945, May 24th, PL, 1978, June 23rd, PL 556, number 94, as amended, 1988, March 30th, PL 304, number 39. Demolition property address, 781 Barrow Road.
Make this so moved.
Nino and Jason. Bill list. Motion of the Borough Council approving the 2015 bill list.
So moved.
Nino.
Second.
And Bill Henderson. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Payrolls. Motion the Borough Council approving the payrolls of September 18th, 25th, and October 2nd and 9th of 2015.
So moved.
Bill Henderson and Neal. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Monthly reports. Motion to accept and pay any commissions due the August 2015 real estate tax collector report.
Yes, so moved.
Nino and Jason, all those in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries. A motion to accept the July 2015 financial report.
So moved.
Nino?
Second.
And Neil? All those in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries. Motion to accept the 2015 police report.
So moved.
Bill and Bill Clusi. Bill Henderson and Bill Clusi. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Motion to accept the August 2015 zoning report.
So moved.
Second. Bill Henderson and Jason, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Real estate tax refund. Motion of the Borough Council regarding the following real estate tax refunds due to changes in the assessment as requested by the real estate tax collector. Year 2015, lot block 322-B-182 for the amount of $142.30. To Donna Goldstrom. Also, year 2014, lot block 322-B-182 for $142.30 for Donna Goldstrom. In year 2013, lot block 322-B-182 for $140.30 for Donna Goldstrom. Year 2014, lot block 255-E-378 for $157.93 for James and Kimberly Kirby. And year 2015, lot block 322-G-278 for $114.81 for Ashley Moritz for the total of $699.64. Is there a motion?
So moved.
Bill Henderson and Bill Clusi. All those in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries. Committee reports. Administration, Bruce is not here. So we'll forego that. Finance, Nino.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. The general funding is $1,230,635.88. Sewer fund, $327,331.70. Garbage fund, $68,907.09. Capital improvement, $25,115.09. Liquid fuel, $176,002.10. Line item of the engineering and legal will exceed the budget project due to unexpected project budget the year of 2016. Work will begin the first week of October. So there's a lot of work that's being done for the 2016. I also had a meeting with the board manager, and I noticed there's a lot of charges sometimes they've been done for a request from council. I'm sure it's necessary. Maybe let's make sure that we are a little more careful, because these people work, they do a lot of favors, but then when they've been ordered to do some work, they have to actually have to get paid. So that, let's try to eliminate it. There is other way things can be done with a little bit of money. There's a lot of things, a lot of time it's being asked from council. Check this, check that, check that. Which a lot of time it's just something that we already know. And so maybe there is other method to do this. Maybe call Lori for reps. Or let's use a little bit different method.
Okay.
We can save a little bit of money. Okay, thanks.
Thank you, Nino.
Sure.
Parks and Recreation, Jason.
Well, baseball, fall ball, and soccer's in full swing. We'll wind down here another month or so. The parks look good. So we can hear more about McLaughlin, how we can move forward, get the funding for the next phase.
Great. Thank you. Public Works.
Public Works, just what Nino says, they're spending a lot of money extra. And we got this project on Bar Hill with that wall. And the way Joe told me that the Borough guys don't want to tackle it. And I feel they should be able to save us some money, because you put that out on bid, it's going to be a big buck. Mm-hmm. And I feel we got to put these guys in the right place to, you know, start doing this little kind of work. Even like that piper talking 100 feet of pipe, they should be able to do that. We'd rather put out on a contract. We got to save money somewhere. And I'd like to get a meeting with them guys too and see which way they want to turn.
Can you meet with the Public Works guys and see what they're comfortable doing?
They have looked at the plan.
Yeah.
Joe met with them and explained the plan to them, and they feel like they don't have the knowledge to do it. They don't feel like they can tackle it.
And we can, so I mean, I understand where they're coming from. I mean, we can't, yeah, it might cost to have somebody come in and do it, but how much would it cost if they said they bit off more than they can chew, and they go and do it, and all of a sudden...
Well, you could hire somebody to come in just to handle, just to let them...
If that's the case, then yeah, that's a whole
somebody that knows something will come in and tell them, hey,
they're here. No, somebody would do that.
Oh, yeah, you get people.
That's something
I'm guaranteed. I mean, it saves Bridgeville a lot of money. That guy never gave a bid yet.
Talk to Lori and see what
he's still laid out.
He's laid out. I mean, me and Joe looked at it. I mean, it can be done. But, you know, nobody wants to attempt it.
They're afraid to.
There's nothing to do. I went through that with my building. It was almost in a creek.
Okay. I said, We'll talk to you guys and see. Because I understand where they're coming from. I wouldn't want to do something that I wasn't comfortable doing, and then it cost me more than that, because I didn't survive.
You have the right people to do the right job.
Right.
You're an electrician, you're a plumber.
Is the idea you're putting forth perhaps to hire somebody on a very short, temporary, like for just to oversee this little project?
A consultant.
A consultant? is that the idea?
That's what I'd get. Somebody.
He wants these organized laborers.
Right, and hire a consultant to supervise them and show them this is how you do it.
Right. So.
Interesting. So. Could have some
error. Looking for that.
Yeah.
All right. Public Safety, Bill Henderson.
This month we met with within committee. We'll continue our lease contract negotiations, so we spent a considerable amount of time doing that. Didn't have a formal public safety meeting this month, but we've got some things we've been looking at in terms of the parking issues in town that we will have a public safety next meeting and continue those thoughts and address some of those issues. So that's all I have.
Thanks, Bill. Mr. Mayor.
I'll follow on with that. The items that were passed at the last meeting, I take it that you're planning on reviewing those, including the street sweeper ordinance as applicability to... At the last meeting, you excluded Baldwin Street from the street sweeper ordinance. You voted to advertise that. As I said at the last meeting, I have some concerns about it remaining in force for St. Clair Street, Main Street, Ramsey, but not Baldwin. I can see both sides of the issue, and I look forward to the Public Safety Committee meeting that you're talking about, you know, for you to come to a recommendation to council for next meeting.
The streets you mentioned, Pat, haven't been enforced for 25 years.
Right.
The additional streets you mentioned, just as the other one wasn't. So we are considering that. And we will address it.
Good. Couple of other items. Tom, the street, the McLaughlin Run, if I understand correctly, and Lori, The center of the stream is the edge of the property owners in the block of run behind Baldwin Street. Typically. So the property owners have responsibility for the wall, the trees, the whatever that's on their bank.
Yes.
And they have control over the ability to solve, in other words, if they've got a wall problem or they've got a tree problem, they should be.
They should be the ones that are.
They should be the ones that are taking it down and they can deal with that.
Yeah.
Again, with whatever DEP issues they have, it's on the property owner can handle his own property and that's his tree, that's his wall.
Yeah, but there's only one thing with that, the borough ruined them walls. And they dredged them, so you can't hold people responsible.
I'm not trying to hold them responsible. I'm saying that if they want to do what you did, which was fix their wall,
right.
It's your wall to fix.
Right.
Not the borough's wall.
After Hurricane Ivan, there were some people that did go in and fix their walls.
Yes. And so that's their walls, their trees, etc.
Yeah. They have the right to fix it.
The other item is the backflow preventers. It's a bad word now, you know, because water company uses them on the water lines. I guess there's no other word for it but backflow preventers on sewage lines or check valves. You had a really great idea that went out almost a year ago, and I was wondering what the status was on, perhaps moving forward.
As far as
the residents of Baldwin Street and helping them with putting in those check valves or backflow preventers. I thought it was a really good idea.
I can pull the letter back out and give it to council and move everyone's memory as far as possible.
And that was in conjunction right with the request that they upgrade their lateral as mm-hmm. part of us right. getting our
right. right. So if we help them with the backflow preventer, right. then they'd upgrade their lateral, and then that's it.
And there's about 10 to 15 affected.
Yeah. Kind of a win-win situation.
I thought it was a really great small sample to work on looking at the bigger problem in a small test group.
I'll pull that out and send it off to everybody again so they can review it.
The last item is to touch on something that Mary brought up. I was at the memorial on September 11th, and there were some very good presentations. Yep. Our fire chief made an excellent one.
Yep.
But as he said, I thought the best presentation was when the little beeps went off and the siren sounded for what seemed to be a fairly routine call. And the firemen who were there quietly gathered and without any commotion proceeded off and got into their fire trucks and went on to risk their lives to protect our community. And I thought about that, and I thought about how many times that happens every day and how grateful I am for those individuals that provide the services for our police, our fire, and our EMS.
Thank you.
That's all.
Thank you, Pat. Police Chief.
No report.
No report. Solicitor.
Thank you, Mr. President. We have my written reports, just a couple highlights. We have the latest draft of the zoning ordinance updates that have been sent by finalizing the BPD and sent to the county for the review, which sets us up to be able to proceed with the public hearing in October. Avenue property next door has been completed. We're processing the tax exemption for next year. Joe may elaborate, or not, what kind of an ongoing on inventory as well in the upcoming second phase of the consent decree. The stated deadline for final.
finalized, and this has been moved to the end of October to honor the ongoing negotiations, which are brought down between us and the regulators and all the engineers and the core lawyers group, which my firm is a part of, have been involved in that, so there'll be more to report next month on that. And finally, I think you mentioned before about the, you guys talked earlier about the neighborhood plans.
And that's all I have to report.
Thank you. Engineer Joe, thanks.
Thank you, Mr. President. Couple items, 2005 pavement maintenance program. Pennsylvania American Water is done with all their work. They got the Ridge Road done for us. And I'm trying to get a pre-construction meeting scheduled with Public Land to proceed with the next phase of the work. Contract B, the Bower Hill Road repairs. Contract with TA Robinson has been executed. We'll be scheduling a pre-construction meeting with them within the next couple of weeks to coordinate the schedule with that work included. We still have an outstanding punch list of items on a 2014 sanitary sewer CCTV inspection work with Jet Jack. We're trying to get that resolved. The CD42 grant pre-application, you approved the resolution and the slums and blight resolution for the demolition of 781 Bower Hill Road. That we submitted the pre-app to the shortlist council of governments last week by the deadline, and we'll use those resolutions to fill out the full application and submit them to the shortlist club for processing with the in October. The New York Street storm sewer, we completed our existing condition survey. We looked at the size of the watershed that comes into that area there, the rear of the properties on New York Street, and determined we've got about 33 acres of land that come to that area. And the existing storm sewer is there is a 15-inch terracotta pipe that's probably on the order of about 75 or years old or older, and it does not have adequate capacity to handle the flow. So therefore, in order to meet the adequate flow, the pipe will need to be increased up to a 24-inch diameter pipe. So the estimate of probable cost for the replacement of the 15-inch storm sewer with a 24-inch storm sewer would be about $206,057.50. So that's something for council to think about. And I would recommend that when we go in there and do that work, that we possibly make the repairs to the sanitary sewer that are in the same vicinity where we have a very oddity in this. In the sanitary sewer where it comes down and it doesn't make a sharp drop and then it turns down even further. So it would make sense to take care of that. I think it's about 120 feet of pipe all the way back over the equipment. That's about another, I think it's about $59,000 more estimated. So you can decide what you want to do with that project.
Well, a couple questions. As far as we haven't had any problems with the storm drain.
Right.
The rain that we had in June, if we continue to maintain that, will we be able to budget that for 2016?
I think we could probably budget for 2016 more. I think, you know, one thing that, you know, we haven't had any significant storms since June. Mm-hmm. You know, I've got a situation in another community where someone's waiting for me to come up with one of these big storms. I just haven't had the opportunity to go there because we haven't had a big storm.
Okay.
So
we were okay in June.
Yeah, we were okay in June. So we've been monitoring it and we just keep an eye on it for now for the budget for 2016. The capital expenditures.
Yeah. Anything else?
I got more. Well, you approved the payment to Solar Construction for the point repairs to date, and we've been we had a pre-construction meeting with Jet Jack for the lining contract. They are going to provide us with a schedule. Inside pipe is significantly completed with the 2015 CCTV inspection and cleaning. We're reviewing the data that they've collected and we'll be making recommendations for final payment once we satisfactorily reviewed all the information. The ADA door openers here at the municipal building and the police department, whether or not we realize it, there's handicapped accessible openers on both sets of doors to let people in. That work was funded to the Allegheny County Department of Economic Development. And once we get an invoice, we'll submit that for payment. I believe that's fully funded by the grant.
Yeah.
And then we went over the Dolph City stuff. So that's all I have.
Well, I was going to miss my old business, but since we're on Joe, Washington Place.
Oh, yes.
That's something you want to bring up now.
See, I would bring it up now, yeah. At the workshop, you have brought you that information relative to the line striping there, related to the intersection of Hickman Street and Washington Avenue. PennDOT has agreed to complete that line striping per the plan as maybe as part of the steps to improve the traffic flow along Route 50. So I ask for a motion to approve the line striping per the Phase 1A improvements plan.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed?
Thank you.
That's the first phase of the task force.
It's one.
One A.
One A.
Thank you very much, Joe. Bill Chilio is at Bingo. So there is no fire report, but I do want to make it a, we had our 31st annual block party, was it last week? Labor Day weekend. And firemen brought a new fire truck over, which they offer it to anybody who has a block party or any kind of event. And it was wildly successful, and I just wanted to thank Bill, even though he's not here, in public, for bringing the truck. It was a big, big hit. Southbridge, Dan.
Do you have statistics for you for the last 2 months, since I wasn't here last month, so I'll provide those after the meeting. And I also want to let you know that finally, after an ambulance accident back in July of last year, we're finally getting that rig back on the road. It's back in the factory at a tune of $150,000. So it'll be out there in the next month or so, nice shiny new, so add to the fleet.
Did you get a new one or?
Rechassis it.
Rechassis it.
Yeah.
Thanks. All right, thank you. Becky's not here for the library. Manager, Lori Collins.
Since I was on vacation, I didn't do a written report. I just want to touch on a couple things. I did already report that the garbage bin has been advertised and bid opening for the October 2nd. We'll let you know what we received with those bids, and in the meantime, we'll move forward with the information that we'll request that we gather. Wanted to know that Council President Tolmer and I met with Representative Ortite to review events within the borough and the task force objectives. He understands what the task force and municipalities are trying to achieve, and we'll continue to assist us in any way that's needed. And I did talk about we are past phase one and the grant for $215,500 for McLaughlin Park. It now has to be approved by the National Park Services. There will be a meeting scheduled on October 8th at 10 a.m. in McDonald to continue to pursue assistance from the Army Corps for all nine of the municipalities that started back.
That's not assistance from the Army Corps. Correct. It is the idea is that the nine member communities who submitted information and requested Army Corps band together and used resources and equipment and manpower to address other issues.
Okay.
That's what it is.
Okay, got it. And they noticed in that the back gathering will be held on this day for those who wish to attend, so anything that has any effect on everyone's invited. We're going to have a flu shot clinic for employees, spouses, council members, families on Monday, September 29th at 8 a.m. Insurance will be taken, so anybody that wants to come stop here, get a flu shot. We're trying to make it easy. I had the real flu, and believe me, you don't want to get it. And if you think you've had it, you really haven't. So please get a flu shot. Engineer Haberman and I met with Andy Waffle of the SPC, along with representatives from Peters Township and South Fayette, regarding the impacts of the Southern Beltway that would connect I-79 Morganza Road and Washington Pike. The purpose of the meeting was to discuss concerns and identify areas of the study and the process, the roads that are going to be affected, and what's going to be happening because of this. And additional meetings will be scheduled, so I'll let you know when that happens and give you an invite. So, but it was just initially just to get the managers and the engineers in to just start talking. And that's all I have.
All right. have something. The neighborhood planning, we talked about at the workshop. We are looking at two neighborhoods in Bridgeville. One is the Ball Street slash Fireville Road corridor, one from Ball Street out towards Upper St. Clair, and then the other one is the Cook School Friar Hill. So this is up by Cook School Road, the park and everything. And basically, it's a little mini, what do you call it, mini comprehensive plan for just a specific neighborhood in Bridgeville, two specific neighborhoods. But wanted to see if we could vote on actually moving forward with implementing this study so we can kind of look at these two neighborhoods, because there's a lot of change going on in both of these areas. Fireville Road and Baldwin Street, obviously, with what's going on there, and then up at Cook School and Friar Hill, with what's going on up there as well. There's a lot of new development going on, and we kind of want to look at it from a Bridgeville point of view and how we can improve those two areas. So, does anybody have any comments, discussion?
Is it for a motion?
Yeah, I'm making a motion.
I just wanted to say something.
Yes.
Channel 11 made great coverage of the police accolades when Officer Young visited a kid's lemonade stand. If you haven't seen it, go online, look. It's cute. Gave Bridgeville Police a nice name.
Thank you. It's also on our Facebook page, too.
Any comments on this? Is there any questions? Making a motion, anybody want a second?
I'll make a motion.
All right, you know, any discussion?
Might I just comment, you should consider this two separate project motions that you can vote on all at one time. If somebody wanted to reserve a nay or one or the other, you could chime in. Otherwise, you're voting two separate proposals for the same price.
Right. Okay. Yeah. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Thank you very much. Any other old business? New business?
I have two questions for the engineer real quick. Ridge, that the area where PA Water Company did Ridge Road. There's also the area where they've replaced water line.
Okay, on the by Tennis Street.
Exactly. Are they coming to do that? I can't remember what the deal was.
What the deal there is they've asked that we do it as part of our contract.
Okay, that was the...
Right, and that's what we're going to do, and then they will reimburse the borough.
Okay, and do we have an idea as to timeline?
Late September.
So this year?
This year, oh yeah,
okay.
This year, yes.
Okay, so we're shooting for this
year. Does
anyone have any tea leaves, any clue as to when PennDOT is thinking about doing Washington Avenue's resurface?
The discussion that I had this afternoon with their project managers, they're looking to do it start here in the next 2 to 3 weeks.
2 to 3 weeks.
Because I wanted to, I was trying to get that coordinated with that piece of conduit path.
Okay, so you.
I'm working on that. So, but they want to get it done before the year, which I'm a little bit surprised myself.
That's why I'm asking.
Yeah, that's a good question.
If you notice, they are stripe, new stripe. I mean, redo the stripes all over Bridgeville, except that because there has to be the stripe. No sense with the paint and dye. That's why they are not done, just in case somebody want to know why or don't know stripe here, because we went no bend up. Thank you.
One last one.
Sure.
I had really not given much thought to the impact of the Southern Beltway on Bridgeville, mainly because I looked at the connection I would take, which is off of State Route 50. I'm curious. Some people mentioned to me that if you're on Boyce Road, your logical way of getting to 79 now would be to head towards where the Southern Beltway is going to connect.
Right. It should, in preliminary discussions, it actually should help us.
That's, and helping South Fayette agree. Let me ask, Lori, when you were at this meeting, did they think that traffic at the end of Boyce would turn left instead of right to get on the 79?
Yes.
So very similar to the long, belabored Boyce Road intersection.
Yes, that was one of the things when we were having the discussions about where all these cars were going to go, one of the discussion was it may be, maybe, a positive for us as far as those vehicles, instead of coming down, you know, entering I-79, or going to make a left, or maybe after St. Clair traffic that's coming through there, we'll go and we'll make a left there. So, you know, further discussions, but it actually may be a positive for us.
The one thing, Pat, you know, the preliminary design shows 79 going over the expressway, and that there'll be a significant cut of earthwork down there, so that would be kind of where that cloverleaf is. And then the other thing is, there's the one that's supposed to tie right into Morgan Road in Cecil Township to take people to the National Cemetery.
But a full cloverleaf tying in?
Yes, that's what the preliminary design shows.
Right, and so you get on the Southern Beltway and it would fly over 79 and you'd put
it
over 79 and
it'll be under it.
Under?
Yes.
Under. Curious to see the amazing engineering that that's all going to take. Thank you.
Any other new business?
Motion to adjourn.
Before I leave, guys.
First thing you said all night.